Hi again. In this module, we'll provide you with a system overview of the Twitter Access Controller. Our property-wide access platform is extended throughout your entire property by the ButterflyMX Twitter Access Controller and readers. These access control products seamlessly connect with your video intercoms, key lockers, elevator controls, and smart locks, providing a complete property-wide access experience. By pairing them with the ButterflyMX access readers like our Keypad, Mullion, and Single Gang readers, you can effortlessly open and manage doors, gates, and elevators using your smartphone, fob, key card, or PIN code. This allows property staff and residents to use a single credential, such as our mobile app, key fob, or PIN code, to access any door, gate, or elevator throughout your entire property. Let's take a look at how our access controller works. The access controller serves as the brain for controlling access, receiving permissions from the ButterflyMX cloud, and sending those commands to unlock the doors or gates as necessary. It's important to note here that even as a cloud-based system, our access controller stores the credential locally, which allows the system to still function in the event of an internet outage. To briefly discuss the system's conditions, it is essential to note that the access controller must be secured in a weatherproof location. The readers are rated IP55 and are suitable for indoor or outdoor installation. Similar to our video intercom, the controller requires power, internet, and RECs. To power the Twitter controller, you'll receive a 12-volt, 5-amp power supply. The power supply is 7 feet long. However, unlike the transformer for our video intercom, it cannot be spliced. So, the distance between the Twitter access controller and the wall outlet should be within 7 feet. For data, our access control supports two modes of internet connectivity, Ethernet and Wi-Fi. However, the preferred method for all of our access control products is a hardwired internet connection through the RJ45 port via Cat5V or Cat6. Lastly, the two-door access controller has two sides that can control one door or gate each. Each side has a dry RECs relay and the wet RECs relay. The wet relay is rated at 12 volts, 1 amp, and can provide power to the locking mechanisms that fits those power requirements. However, for those that require more power, such as gates or large mag locks, we recommend using the dry RECs relay and using an external power source for power. When connecting a ButterflyMX access reader to our controller, we recommend using an OSDP compatible, shielded, 22 gauge twisted pair multi-conductor. However, other cables may be compatible for our readers. More information about our wiring requirements can be found in our two-door access controller installation guide, on the installation resources section of our website, butterflymx.com. Connecting an access keypad or reader is a pretty straightforward process as the terminals on the relays are color-coded and the reader receives its power and internet from the controller. Now, let's get into a couple of features that are supported by the two-door access controller. The first being a fire relay input. If you have a fire alarm access panel that provides a signal, you do have the option of connecting the fire alarm system to the two-door access controller to automatically unlock all of the doors and gates connected to the controller. An additional feature is a battery backup that can be introduced to protect against any power outages, and that can be terminated to the battery backup relay on the two-door access controller. Those are just some of the features supported by the system. If you're interested in the rest, feel free to pause this video and check them out on our installer resources webpage. The final note I want to make is on the use of existing fobs with a controller. Key fob technology can be complex when integrating third-party devices, so determining its compatibility requires a two-step process. We highly recommend you purchase ButterflyMX key fobs as they're guaranteed to work and are secure. If, however, you'd like to test if your fob is compatible, here's how. Our two-door access controllers have shown the possibility of being able to integrate with existing fobs when they meet the following three criteria. The fobs cannot be encrypted, cannot use proximity, and they also cannot use weakened protocol. If your fob checks those three boxes, we ask that you send one of your fobs over to our engineering team for testing to ensure it is 100% compatible with our system. That concludes the installation section of our two-door access controller. Up next is a brief quiz on the materials we just covered.